2007 Pro Tool, and I'm currently doing Master of Professional Accounting at CDU Waterfront Campus. So in this semester, I've been fortunate enough to obtain a professional placement at CDU Free Tax Clinic. So in this presentation, I will talk about my experience, the skills that I've acquired, my strengths and weaknesses, what I've been through at the end of the internship period. So first of all, I'd like to give you guys a brief outline of my presentation, so you guys will know what I'll be talking about. So first, I'll give a brief introduction of the CDU Free Tax Clinic, its organizational structure, my roles as an intern, the portal learning necessary for me to function properly in the office, the skills acquired, my reflection of graduate attributes, my personal strengths and weaknesses, and my strategy to overcome the weakness, my achievement, and last but not least, I will conclude my presentation. So first of all, CDU Free Tax Clinic was first launched in June 2019 by Professor Indra Abhisekera, and the best thing about the tax clinic is that it is free for everyone. Well, not for everyone, but for eligible individuals and entities, which I will go over after this shortly. So it provides a valuable experience for accounting students. It is of benefits to the wider society, and it is further supported by the Australian Taxation Office, so which is great. So for accounting students, they'll be able to acquire real-life hands-on experience for dealing with real-life clients, so they'll be more ready when they graduate, and they will be able to fit in the professional environment better. And then for the wider society, tax clinic will show that the accounting education is very relevant for small businesses and individuals, because it is very practical and relevant to them. Though we have to do the tax return every year, so this is a very nice aspect of the tax clinic. So for the students at the tax clinic, they will be able to provide tax consultation to our clients, responding to ATO notice, reporting meetings and filing requirements, applying for remission of penalties, negotiating a payment plan should clients have a tax payable amount, computing the client's tax liabilities, their tax law rights and obligations, such as lodging tax return every year, even though even if they didn't earn anything, they still need to lodge a tax return using non-lodgement advice, and then professional representation for individual and businesses. So as I've said earlier, not everyone is eligible for the service. For individuals, there are three criteria, which is currently unrepresented, or in other words, they don't have a tax agent, and they have reside in the Northern Territory, and they have they need to have an annual tax annual income of lower than $60,000. And for small businesses, not-for-profit organization, and small charities, they need to also satisfy three criteria. They need to have a Northern Territory residency, they do not have a tax agent, and they meet the eligible requirement to be small businesses, not-for-profit, and charities. So this is the organizational structure of the tax clinic. There is two volunteers for work integrated learning students under the supervision of SAMAF tax practitioner, which is Ali Dirani and Manfred Letson. And Raul David and Mr. Simon Morris will act as a clinic manager, and at the end of each month, we will prepare Raoul David and Simon Morris for approval, and then it will be forwarded to the ITO. So my role as an intern includes welcoming and attending to client. So whenever a client comes to the office, I will have them take a seat, offering them sweets and drinks, and then making small talk, getting to know them a little better so we can fill in the tax return more accurately. And we also have them log into their MyGov account, and then we can fill and assist them with tax lodgement and tax related inquiries, particularly in deductions. And then I also have to maintain the client's database on an Excel file. And I also have administrative assistance, which includes, but not limited to, cleaning around the office, handling phone calls, setting up appointments, making a Google Calendar reminder to the teams and the clients. And then for portal learnings, MyGov portal, which is the most important one and crucial one. So in this portal, we'll be able to access Australian job search, the ATO, central link, child support, and so on. But the primary focus is on Australian Taxation Office, because essentially we are offering taxation consultation advice to our clients. And then there's MyGov ID, which is an app which can validate our clients' identity so that they can log into MyGov and other business portal more easily. And then there's Relationship Authorization Manager. So sometimes the clients can authorize someone to do their tax-related tasks on behalf of them. And for the skills that I've acquired interpersonal skills. Of course, in the office, I have to communicate with the team clients, the team members, the tech practitioner, and our clients. And I also acquire professional communication skills, which is writing emails and handling phone calls in a professional manner, so that I can leave a good impression on the clients, so that they will contact us again in the future if they have further issues, or they would want to set up an appointment with us. And then for Excel skills, as I said earlier, I have to maintain a client database on an Excel file, so I need to have a certain knowledge about the Excel skills. And then I also acquire team working and delegating skills, because normally when a client comes to the office, they will need us to help with their current year tax lodgement. Sometimes they also didn't do the previous year, so we will also help them for that year as well. So there's 2 years for each client, but in extreme case, there will be much more work. For example, I remember a gentleman come to us with 20 years having not lodged his tax return, so it is a very big workload, and I have to divide the task into smaller tasks, so each of the team members will take on several years so that we can complete the task more effectively and quickly. So for application of theoretical knowledge, I applied the knowledge in professional practice experience, because I need to know what the employers and the clients requires me to do, and I have to do them. And then for Australian taxation law, I have to know about it, because what we're offering is taxation advice. So of course I have to know about Australian taxation law, otherwise I cannot give them advice. And then accounting principle. I need to have a sound knowledge about accounting principle on income and expense. Sometimes I need to do the goods and services tax for the clients. I need to know about their source of income, the income expense, liabilities, and so on. So, and I also apply knowledge of auditing, because whenever the clients want to add a deduction into their tax return, we need to actually acquire that expense. For example, it could be receipt, or it could be a picture of the receipt or a bank statement that state they have spent this amount. Or we could ask for the payslip so we could reconcile with the information uploaded on MyGov by the employers. And then accounting information system, we have to maintain a client. I have to maintain a client database using the cloud. So of course, it helps us manage and track the clients more easily, so we can prepare the monthly report more quickly. And then corporate finance. Of course, I have to know about corporate finance because we don't only offer service to the individual, but also other entities such as small business, sole trader, and not-for-profit, and so on. And from my reflection of graduate attributes, as I've said in the previous slide, I have applied my knowledge to the application of knowledge during my time at the office. I have to communicate with everyone, including the clients, the tax practitioner, the team leaders, and team members. And then I also have to assume the team leader responsibilities, and I have to make a decision sometimes, because every 2 weeks student will assume a role of the team leaders, and they will be able to assume the responsibility for that 2 weeks. And then the flexibilities, we act as a team, so whenever a team member encounter any trouble, we will offer whatever assistance that will be able to help them and the clients. And then for leadership, as I said earlier, everyone in the tax office act as a leader, so of course me, myself, I have some leadership skills as well. And for teamwork also, sometimes the workload is large, so I have to divide them into smaller tasks and delegate them to the team members, so I will not overburden myself and I will lose focus. And for my personal strength, I have a finance and accounting background, so for the taxation related issue, I'll be able to grasp them quite quickly. And I also have advanced Excel skills, because during my finance degree, I have to do quite a lot of Excel spreadsheets, setting up calculation, budgeting, and so on. So I have a high focus and concentration. I have a high attention to details, particularly in numerical details. And I have a fast improving and adapting to new environment, because it only took me 2 days to get used to the tax clinic environment, even though I started later than everyone else. And for my weaknesses, I have a lack of practical knowledge or hands-on experience. This is expected, because that's why I'm here. I'm trying to get into the industry by getting exposure to real-life clients, so that I'll be more confident and less nervous when I enter into the professional environment. And then I'm not very talkative, and I can be passive at times, but I have gradually changed, because I have to make small talk with everyone during the day, and also have small talk with our clients, so that I can get to know them better and fill in the details more accurately. And then sometimes I can be overly self-reliant, because I used to do whatever it is that I can do, I used to do them on my own. But in the office now, sometimes the workload is very high. For example, the 20 years of non-lodgement gentleman, I have to divide the task into smaller one, and then I have to rely on others to do wider social network circle, because I know everyone. After the tax clinic operation, I know everyone in the tax clinic teams, the tax professional, and some of the clients as well. And some of them offering me new opportunities, whether it is data entry job or MYOB knowledge. I'm very grateful for them because in Darwin it is very small, and I'm pretty sure that we will meet each other again. And then for positive, I also have a positive feedback from mentors, which I'm very grateful. And last but not least, I would like to acknowledge Ms. Rupali Misra, Ms. Jaina and Baldwin, Mr. David Rahul, Mr. David Long, Mr. Simon Morris, and the tax practitioner at SAMAF, specifically Ali Dirani and Manfred Letson, for being for providing our student with such valuable experience. Thank you, everyone. And